Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and salam sejahtera. Welcome to our e-learning module for this course ISO IEC 27001 2022 Information Security Management System. My name is Azwarin bin Ahmad Elias Muhammad Yusof, consultant from SIRIM STS. So for this module, I will share with you about the understanding and also the concept of Information Security Management System according to standard ISO IEC 27001 2022. Okay, the course objective for this module is first to understand the principle and general concept of information security management system and to enable to apply SMS within the organization. The second concept is to understand the requirement within the clause of the ISO IEC 27001-22 and the change made to the standard. And also the third one is to understand the information security controls within the Annex A of ISO IEC 27001-2022. And the fourth one is to understand the required SMS policies in order to manage the security of information asset of the organization. So we will begin with session 1. So in session 1, I will give some overview and also introduction about information security management system. So in information security, the first term that we need to understand is information asset. So information is a meaningful facts and data, and asset is actually anything that has value. So information asset is asset that carries information. So if organization need to identify what kind of information asset that are available and they use in their organization. Another concept that we need to understand in information security is about CIA. So SMS is about protecting organization information asset in terms of its confidentiality, integrity and also availability. So what is CIA? So CIA is quite essential and important in our information security. So the first concept is confidentiality. So confidentiality is protecting sensitive information from unauthorized disclosure. So organization need to protect any confidential, sensitive and also important information within their organization from any unauthorized access or disclosure. The second concept is integrity. So integrity is safeguarding the accuracy, completeness, authenticity of information designed to prevent data from being modified or misused by unauthorized party. So organization need to safeguard their information in terms of the accuracy of the information, completeness and also authenticity of the information. So if the information have integrity, your customer and also the user will trust and also have confidence about information in your organization. The third concept that we need to understand is availability. So what is availability? So is to ensuring that information and vital service are available to user when required. So organization need to ensure that information is available when your user or your customer required or needed to use the information. So this is three concept that we need to understand and also apply in information security. Another concept that we need to understand is authenticity. So what is authenticity? Authenticity is necessary to ensure that the data, transaction, communication or documents are genuine. It is also important for authenticity to validate that both parties involved are who they claim to be. So the keyword here is we have to ensure that our information and data are genuine or original. So examples such as nowadays most of our organization use digital signature. So what is the procedure and also method in order to ensure that digital signature that we use within our organization are safe and protected from any unauthorized use? The second concept that we need to understand also is non-repudiation. What is non-repudiation? Non-repudiation imply one intention to fulfill their obligation to a contract. So it also implies that one party of a transaction cannot deny having received a transaction, nor can the other party deny having sent a transaction. Example, a cryptographic system. So in a non-repudiation, it is our obligation and also the user obligation to fulfill their contract and also agreement on how they could use the information. So any party cannot breach the contract or the obligation that they have agreed before they use the information. So this is five terms that you need to understand: CIA, authenticity, and also non-repudiation.